My name is Jim Herring. I'm a CW5 in the North Carolina Army National Guard.
Well, I've been in the North Carolina National Guard since 2004. Before that, I was in the Virginia National Guard for 10 years, and then in the Army Reserve before that, and then active duty before that. So since 1979, I've served 38 years and a few months of total military service. My first enlistment, I was an MP at Fort Myer, Virginia. And then I left the military for a couple of years, and when I re-enlisted in the reserve, I did so to become a Special Forces communications sergeant. May of 2006, we were mobilized for Iraq. It was in Iraq where the team that I was on, SFODA 2084, was stationed in Bakuba, Iraq. And that's where I was awarded the Silver Star and the Bronze Star Medal with Valor device and a Purple Heart and a second Bronze Star Medal for service. So I was awarded the Silver Star in for actions in Iraq in December 2006. We had been in a couple of ambushes already that day, and then we got into a great big ambush. My driver got shot through an opening in the up-armored Humvee, and he got shot in the leg, and he crashed our Humvee. My machine gunner was fully engaged with the enemy at the time, and we had to get out of the ambush site. Our truck was shot up pretty bad. I mean, it's a miracle that nobody else was hurt in our convoy, just the driver. It's hard to believe, looking at the glass, that the machine gunner wasn't wounded, but somehow he made it out through it, and we were able to fight out of the ambush and get back to our base. There was a road that led from Bakuba to Baghdad, and that was the route that all the Al-Qaeda guys and any anti-Iraq forces would come from. The Al-Qaeda guys were digging in these huge IEDs under the road. That particular battery had lost a lot of soldiers. Battery commander actually came to our company commander in Fob Warhorse and said, "Hey, you know, we're having a terrible time down here, losing a lot of guys. Can you guys help us out?" We were standing in one of the IED craters on the road, and I looked over and I saw a copper wire. So we traced the copper wire across the field about 100 meters, and on the other side of this small dirt road, there was an upside down bucket and a soda bottle and cigarette butts right where the guy had been sitting with the copper wire and the batteries to initiate the IED and blow it up underneath these armored vehicles. We let it go for a couple of weeks until everybody got comfortable again with how things were. You know, about 3 o'clock in the morning, I woke up everybody and woke up the Iraqis and had all their phones taken away from them. Didn't tell them where we were going, just told them to get their equipment, get ready to get go. We staged our vehicles and we headed south out of Bakuba towards Khan Beni Saad, which was a small little town that was just south of Bakuba, in between Bakuba and Baghdad. It was probably about 5 minutes to five in the morning or something like that. It was pitch black dark, so dark you could hardly see your hand in front of your face. Sure enough, about the time I said we're not gonna get them, one of the guys shouted out, "Hey Chief, here they come." And here came a bongo truck down the road, guys in it, black balaclavas on. We lit them up with lights, and they all had AK-47s, and they started up and we started up. Ended up killing all of them. But from that moment on, we didn't have any more IEDs on that road. Then I was honored to be part of his Portraits of Courage book, where he actually painted a portrait of me, which is in a trifold inside the book. It's a large panel. And the panel in the museum is 16 feet long, and I appear in the second panel from the left. The 38 plus years has gone by just like that. You know, I can close my eyes and I can still see myself as a Spec 4, you know, and sometimes I act like one too, but I've always been that kind of guy, just, you know, do what needs to be done kind of guy, no matter what, you know, even if it's taking trash out, you know. So to me, those awards are awesome. I mean, I got President Bush to sign them, you know, but they're just still just doing your job, you know. If I got them or didn't get them, I still did my job.